Hello guys, welcome to my channel. Welcome to Know Thyself, a learning hub. Today we are back with a video on articles. Articles is one of the main topic for all the job seekers, students. In all the competitive exams, we get questions from articles. So here I'm going to give you three simple tips. In fact, in this video, I'm going to give you two simple tips where you can identify the articles, what to use, and we will learn how to understand, use, and identify articles. So, let's start. What's an article? So, usually, where is this article placed in a sentence? It's always placed before a noun or a noun phrase. Now, most of the times, articles modify a noun or a noun phrase. What do we call a word which modifies a noun? We call it an adjective. So basically, an article is an adjective. So like adjectives, what do articles do? Articles modify nouns. There are other things like determiners and all. I'm not getting into that as of now. What are articles? They are adjectives. So how many articles does English language have? It has two articles. One is definite, the other is indefinite. So of course, in indefinite, we use a and an. That's a different story. They both are considered as one because a means one, an means one. We use the for the definite things, specific things. If we are speaking about a specific thing, we use the. If we are speaking about something in general, we use a or an. Again, where do we use them? We use them before, I'm mentioning a and an, or a or an, are used before singular countable nouns. A or an are used before singular countable nouns. Then what about them? It can be used before singular or plural. But what is the main point to be caught while using the or the, however you pronounce it? It is used to refer specific or particular nouns. And a or an are used non-specific or non-particular nouns. For example, let's read the book. Let's read the book. Now, what did I mention? What did I say? So I'm meaning a specific book. That means me and the listener with whom I'm speaking, we both are referring to the same book. That means the book is already in the knowledge of my listener and me. But when I say, let's read a book, here, even I'm not sure what I'm going to read, even the listener is not sure what he is going to read or what we are going to read. And we proceed. We proceed with a and an. So we always remember that using a or an depends on the sound, not the letter. From our childhood, you know, we were taught if a word starts with a vowel, before that we have to use an. If a word starts with a consonant, before that we have to use a. But not vowel letter, not vowel letter, and not consonant letter. They are vowel sound and consonant sound. So we have to go with the sound. And here, as I told you, I'm going to give you a simple tip. A simple tip to identify what to use, a or an. Of course, as we all know, a, which we use as article a, we use it before the nouns or singular countable nouns which start with a consonant sound. Here, a boy, a car, a bike, a zoo. So, b, k, b, z, all of them are consonant sounds. Whereas, an is used before singular countable nouns beginning with a vowel sound. Here we can see an elephant, an egg, an apple, an ice cream. So a, a, I. All of these are vowel sounds. And as I mentioned, I'm gonna reveal the trick. The trick that I mentioned is here on the screen. We can see Devanagari Lipi and Telugu. The sounds are a, a, e, e, u, u, a, a, i, o, o, amaha. Okay, amaha is not mentioned, but still. The trick is, if you get a word and you are a fix, you are in a fix, whether to use a or an, just think of the word in your mother tongue, if it is Devanagari or Telugu. If the first letter falls between a to aha, that is a vowel sound, we use an. సెప్ అంటే ఒకవేళ ఏ పదమన్నా వచ్చి ఏ వర్డ్ అన్నా ఇచ్చినా ఆ వర్డ్ని ఒకసారి తెలుగులో అనుకోండి, లేదంటే హిందీ అయితే హిందీలో అనుకోండి. దాంట్లో అంటే దాని మీనింగ్ కాదు అనుకోవాల్సింది, ఆ వర్డ్ని అనుకుంటే ఫస్ట్ లెటర్ ఆ నుండి అహా మధ్యలో ఉంటే దాన్ని వవల్ సౌండ్ కాబట్టి మనం యాన్ వాడతాము. అది కాకుండా ఇంకేది ఉన్నా మనం అ వాడతాం. సెప్ యాజ్ సింపుల్ యాజ్ దాట్. సో ఇఫ్ ద ఫస్ట్ లెటర్ ఫాల్స్ బిట్వీన్ అ టు అహా వి యూజ్ యాన్, ఇఫ్ నాట్ వి యూజ్ అ. Here are some examples. University, utensil, European, universal, one rupee note, one-eyed man. All these words are starting with a vowel letter but not a vowel sound. So we have to use a because when, okay, we'll check out the trick whether it works here. University, yeah. Would it fall between a to a? No. It falls in ya, ra, la, va there. So it's not a part of a to a group. So no and. Only a. Same with utensil, same with European, same with one rupee note, same with one-eyed man. But on the other hand, if we see an honorable man, an honest man, an hour, an yellow umbrella, all these, though they are starting with a consonant letter, but they are giving out a vowel sound. See, H is silent, H is being not voiced here. So an honorable, so it's a part of Atvaha. An honest, it's a part of Atvaha. An hour, an yellow umbrella, all these are starting with a vowel sound. So we use an. So there is a quiz. Try doing it and please mention how many of you got everything correct. We can eliminate the doubt between a or an. Now coming to the one trick you have to remember, or one rule, one solid rule you have to remember is, we have to use the definite article when you know exactly what you are talking about, or when you expect the listener to recognize it. That means, as I gave in the example at the beginning of the video, when me and the listener, or the speaker and the listener, share common language, when both of them are on the same page and speaking about the same thing, the exact thing, the definite thing, we use them. See, when I mention moon with somebody here, so am I mentioning about the moon which circles around the earth, or am I mentioning about the Phobos, the moon of Mars? No, right? If I'm speaking to the Martian, then okay, when I say the moon, he might think of Phobos and I might think about our moon. But when I'm speaking to a man on our planet, of course, when I mention moon, it means the moon, one and only. So me and the listener, we both share the same thing, right? Similarly, when I mentioned the prime minister, when I'm speaking to a fellow Indian, when I mention a prime minister, am I speaking about the prime minister of a neighboring country? No, right? I speak about our prime minister. So I mentioned the prime minister. So when we share the common language, or when the speaker and the listener know about the thing that they are speaking, and they are speaking common about a particular thing, about a definite thing or a specific thing, we use them. And of course, there are a few things to remember as well. But irrespective of these rules which I'm going to tell you, even if you follow this simple rule, that if both the speaker and the listener have common knowledge about what they speak, yeah, we can use them. But what are those common things we can share? One, it's used before the country, and here If the country is single, we won't use it. We won't use the, or in fact, any article. But if it is a group, if it's a group of states or islands, yes, the United States, the Netherlands, the Philippines, and if I introduce a particular noun and if I repeat it in the same paragraph, we use the or the. So here we have an example. I saw a movie last night. The movie was entertaining. A man ran into the street. A car hit the man. So in both examples, we introduced about that noun, but when the same noun was repeated, we used the definite article the, because we are speaking about that particular noun which we have introduced already. So I saw a movie last night. So last night I went to a movie, any movie. But when I continue about it, about which movie am I speaking? I'm speaking about the same movie which I saw last night. So the movie was entertaining. And a man ran into the street. Of course, in the street there are many people. But a man ran. So out of many, one ran. And a car hit the man. Now, about whom I'm speaking? I'm speaking about the man who ran into the street. Not everyone ran into the street, right? One particular person went and he got hit by the car. And before directions, the South Pole, the North Pole, the East, the West, the South, the Northeast. And names of oceans, rivers, seas, deserts, forests, canals, mountains. In fact, here, most of us get confused. If it's a single mountain, we are not going to use the before it. If it's a mountain range, yes. If it's a group of islands, yes. If it's about newspapers, yes. If it's about musical instruments, yes. And about inventions, yes. So before all, yes. Like the Pacific Ocean, the Mediterranean Sea, the Ganga, the Suez Canal, the Atlantic Ocean, the Sahara Desert, the tabla, the violin, the piano. And of course, there are many. Like name of monuments, memorials, parks, or national shrines. See. Why am I mentioning all this? Of course, it's in grammar book and we are mentioning, yes, but if it is a monument, if it is a memorial, if it's a park, or if it's a national shrine, if it's so famous, that means we share common knowledge about them. See, the mountain ranges, yes, of course, everyone knows about it. Every country has famous rivers. Because all the civilizations started on the banks of rivers. So, in this way, we share common knowledge about that. So when I mention Pacific Ocean, is there any more Pacific Oceans on Earth? No, only one. So we share a common knowledge about it. And again, here, monuments like the Red Fort, White House, the Parliament, these are always in the common knowledge of the people in that particular country. At least globally, that's okay, but at least in that particular country. So we can use. And then names of colleges, universities, or other schools, if the title of the school has off or fur in it. Usually, we don't use the before university names and school names, unless they are meant for a special purpose or they are meant for something. Okay, so what are the keywords to look into? If the name of the university or school has off or fur in it, or if it starts with university or something, that's a different technique. But here, off or fur, please remember that. See, the University of Maryland, the Maryland School for the Deaf, the Model Secondary School for the Deaf. So here, we have this off or fur, and we are mentioning and we are specific about a particular thing here. So we are using the. When I mention the library. So we are in the same university, we have only one library there, yes, the library, the dorm, the cafeteria, or the bookstore in that particular campus. But do not use a, an, or the if a building or campus is named after a person. Please do not use. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe my channel.